Well, you know, the thing about money is that it's a very funny thing, especially coming from the point of art. You know, art demands that you express yourself, that you be original, which in itself can be the antithesis of a business model. Business model says, find out what the people want, create it, and give it to them. That can hardly be original, if you get what I mean. So it seems as if that they are cross purposes. But what I find is that if you do good work that serves a purpose, you understand, that satisfies a need, money will follow. And if you hone your crafts to the point where you become the best, then you will attract the highest paying clients. Because those who are looking the best, are looking for the best, are willing to pay the highest. You understand? So it's a very funny thing, you know. First, you have to start with trying to be the absolute best that you can. Because what then happens? Some people say, oh, let us find the one that is selling and let us do that. Then we'll make money. But when you do that, you betray this kind of mediocrity and this kind of, how do I put it? It's always you're replicating what has been done before. Then people see it as a copy of the original. But when your goal is to make something great that will satisfy you, the urge to create, invariably people start to see how unique your work is. And then the money then follows. So I always tell young people, first believe in yourself, because that's the problem. People don't believe in themselves enough to trust their gut instincts. To say, you see, this is what I want to do and this is how I want to do it. I don't really care if anybody wants to buy it. It's my own way. And when you do that and you stick to it long enough and you do it well enough, people start to see how you stand out from the crowd. You know, I would tell people, art in itself is not so much about problem solving. It's about creating problems. So if you create a problem that nobody has found a solution to, and then you solve it, you become the only one with the solution to that problem. You get what I mean? Like, you know, for instance, you know, when they brought the iPad, and, you know, Steve Jobs was like, you know, the iPad becomes what you make it. A lot of times people didn't know what the iPad was until they bought one. But people didn't say, oh, we want an iPad before he started making them. You get what I mean? That's a typical example of how art works, you know? So for me, it was me having fun and trying to enjoy myself creating the kind of images that excite me. And I found out that invariably some other people share in those sentiments with the images that I created. And I found out that it does have some value that it gives to the audience. You know, it's either it's got a high aesthetic level, or it's got visual impact, or it's got cultural impact. You know, after a while, people started looking at the way I told my own stories, and they want to pay me to help them tell their stories with my style.